My father was a church organist. And he was, in fact, the day I was born, he was called to the hospital from the church service. This part of the training of a Lutheran schoolteacher is also with music. And he's quite good at music. He played in the Chicago World's Fair. He gave a recital in 1934, whatever the year was. He gave several recitals I have programs of, and I inherited some of his organ music. When I was young, I studied piano. But my piano teacher also knew something about the organ. So when I was 12 years old, I had a year of organ lessons instead of piano lessons. And so I learned a little bit about the instrument at that time. I met E. Power Biggs. He came to Milwaukee to give a concert that year. I rode in the car with him to the recital, actually. I didn't know how famous a man he was, but he was the man who brought organ music to recording in America. So that was it, though. I went back to piano. In high school, I was playing the piano with the accompanying the band in fraternity. All the parties, I was playing piano. We would sing a lot of songs, mostly Broadway shows, tunes. And I enjoyed playing the piano. For example, when we went to Norway for my first time away, instead of running a TV set, we rented a piano. And Jill and I played four-hand music with each other about every night. So I've always liked piano, but in the 1960s, when I'm at Caltech, we were singing in the choir, and somebody called me on Saturday and said, "Don, our organist and choir director has just come down with a detached retina and he's in the hospital. Is it true that you took organ lessons once when you were a teenager? And can you fill in at tomorrow's service?" So I went to the church and I tried to remember how to play, and on Sunday I played the service. And then at that time, in order to recover from a detached retina, you had to sit still for some months with your head in sort of rigid while the thing was healing the way they did it. So for the next 6 months, I was the organist of a church there. In Pasadena, there was a great tradition of fine organ playing. A man named Clarence Mader and many of his students were in the churches around there. So they had some of the best in the country, actually, at the time. So I started attending recitals of organists. They also invited the best organists from the East to this chapter of the American Guild of Organists. So I began to realize that there's a lot of really great literature for the organ. I met a few people who had organs in their home, and I kind of thought that was a cool thing. So when I had my year in Princeton, a large number of the best organists in the country were headquartered in Princeton, and I had heard some of them in Pasadena while I was there. So I took classes at Westminster Choir College, where these people were associated in Princeton. I audited the classes. I found it was kind of strange, as a full professor, going back to taking lessons again, where somebody would tell me what to do. This was quite a come down for somebody who'd been used to being king of the world. But anyway, I had a great, excellent teacher in Princeton, and she gave me lots of good music that I could begin to learn. So the idea was planted in me that pipe organ music is one of the great pleasures of life.